I mean, the way her hair was, you guys, her hair, crazy ass hair all over her head. Now, I've never been in jail, but I'm pretty sure they let you run a comb through your hair. But you know what? It's coming from Tyler Perry, and he is a black man, and his audience is primarily black women. So, you know, if Tyler says it's okay, it must be okay. This is Dee, and welcome to the Come Up Straight Up, a channel dedicated to hypergamy for women of 40 and over. You guys, welcome to my new channel. As many of you know, I was doing a hypergamy series on my other channel, Pretty and Things. Be sure to continue to support that one too, please. And I decided that this topic, this issue, was worthy of its own channel. So here we are. I created this new channel to focus strictly on this topic. So this is my first video, and honey, we are going to get into it. There is a new movie on Netflix, a new Tyler Perry movie called A Fall from Grace. And it is the story of an older woman, younger man, romance, marriage gone haywire, with her ending up killing him and in prison and everything that ensues before her incarceration and after. Now, this video will not be a review of the movie. I'm gonna go over like things that have been discussed in the past by myself and how it relates to this woman, how she is depicted in this film. So yes, there will be spoilers, but if you have not seen the film and you still want to, this video will not ruin it for you. It is a 2-hour film, and yes, there will be a few spoilers, but the focus here will be on Grace and the choices she made that put herself in the situation. When we first meet Grace, she is in jail, and she is, you know, visited by her attorney, the public defender, a young black woman. And essentially, this story is told in flashbacks. How she met this guy, Shannon, and the events that ensued that got her to this point. This character made, you know, so many of the mistakes that we have discussed in this hypergamy series. When they first met, they met in an art gallery. Like I said, there will be a few spoilers. They met in this art gallery, and he was, you know, basically showing his art. I mean, if you're showing in an art gallery, I mean, not anyone does that unless you are a, you know, prominent artist or up-and-coming artist. And, well, first of all, let me get into him before I say anything, okay? Tyler Perry, what were you thinking? This dude has the 1992 Bobby Brown Every Little Step I Take haircut, like the high top fade, and he dresses crazy. Like, who dresses like that? You know, when we get into the whole Tyler Perry thing, you guys, I've got so many things I'm gonna call him out on. But so Shannon, the soon-to-be husband, pursues Grace, and he calls her out, you know, he calls her to go out for dinner. And he invites her to this like diner. It's a cute diner that I know. This is what he said to her. She gets there, and it is a raggedy ass dive. Okay, and this is mistake number one. Now, mind you, Grace is a professional woman, an educated woman, and definitely the type of woman who you would see as, you know, sort of, you know, upper middle class. She was in fact married to a man of means, a guy who owned a mortgage company. Again, we're gonna get into that when we talk about Tyler Perry. Now, I understand her being flattered by the attention of this younger man, especially after she was lonely. She got out of a marriage of, you know, 20 years that, you know, ended in divorce, where he cheated on her. I understand that she had not had any attention from a man, any positive attention, for a long time. I get that. But she did not ask her just normal questions that you need to know of anyone that you are dating. Do you have any brothers and sisters? Where were you born? Where were you raised? Your parents, Did you go to college? If so, where'd you go? Where'd you go to high school? These are normal questions. And the biggest problem I had with this character and with this film was how they depicted this woman as a victim. I mean, the way her hair was, you guys, her hair, crazy ass hair all over her head. Now, I've never been in jail, but I'm pretty sure they let you run a comb through your hair. This woman was going to plead guilty, even though she was facing the death penalty. She was not even going to put up a defense. She was just going to basically sign her death warrant. She was perfectly willing to do that without a fight. The attorney wanted to speak to the prosecutors to see if she could get a better deal. The prosecution was like, no, instead of death, we're going to get, you know, our proposal is life. And yeah, we'll think about moving her to a prison close to her son. The attorney presented this to Grace, and Grace was like, well, you know, if that's the best you can do. And that is really what I found one of the many things I found bothersome about the depiction of this character and this black woman. You guys, think about it. You know, there are criminals who, you know, are standing over the bloody body with the knives in their hand, covered in blood, with, you know, caught on video, and they still plead not guilty. They go to court and make the prosecution prove their guilt. I mean, it's human nature to defend yourself. She had to be convinced that she was worthy of a defense. Another choice that got her into this situation was ignoring the red flags. And that the big red flag in the beginning is, if something is too good to be true, it usually is. Look, I'm not saying that there aren't good men out there. Obviously, you know, we believe there are. You know, what is the point of this channel? But there are a lot of con men like this Shannon guy, and just men just looking to take advantage. And for me, like, the biggest red flag in the beginning is, as I said, him asking her about her finances, like the first date. That is a red flag that cannot and should not be ignored. Why are you asking about my finances on the first date? What is your objective? You know, if anything, you guys, that should tell you right there that this man is not a provider. He's asking basically for what you will be able to do for him, or what you will be able to contribute, if you have the means to contribute. Okay, this is not a person you even want to deal with. Somebody who's asking you about your finances, first date or at all. That is a huge red flag. Another red flag, you guys, was how over the top he was, and how he was laying it on so thick and taking her out to see, like, the butterfly, you know, the fireflies. And yes, these were nice romantic gestures, but it's like, it wasn't real. You were only seeing one side of him. And that was clearly his representative, not obviously who he was. And she did not get to know him, or she did not spend enough time with him to learn who he was. Shannon isn't really even really his real name. She didn't ask him any information about himself, and he didn't share any real information about himself. The bottom line is, Grace saw Shannon as the prize. She almost acted as if he was doing her some kind of favor by being with her. Shortly after they got married, his demeanor changed. His attitude towards her changed, like, he flipped on her like that. And obviously that was a red flag. He's on the phone, you know, talking to somebody. And she comes downstairs and she asks him, like, you know, who are you talking to? And he's like, I don't like to be questioned. And it's like, say what? I mean, this is your husband. And he just flipped on her right away. So I would say right then and there, she should have known like something was up. Another mistake, you guys, that Grace made, and this is huge, was allowing this man full access to her finances. He owned her home, and as her husband and the law, you know, and per the laws of that state, he was on the deed to her home. Therefore, he was entitled to take out a second mortgage on it and, you know, take that money without any input or approval from her. You give a stranger who swept you off your feet full access to your finances, and then you're surprised when he steals from you. And it's the same old song and dance of the black woman going above and beyond, giving, 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 and not receiving, essentially being the main breadwinner and being happy to do so, not requiring anything of him. She didn't require anything, so she didn't get anything. This is why self-esteem and self-confidence are so important, and having standards and boundaries. These things are invaluable. We are prizes, but so many of us do not love ourselves enough to know that. We don't love ourselves and we aren't confident within ourselves to even expect to be taken to a nice restaurant on a first date. The bottom line is, if you are willing to settle for less, less is exactly what you will get. Now I'm going to talk about Mr. Tyler Perry, because I really took exception to how this black woman, Grace, was written. And this woman had two homes, two husbands, two homes, and both husbands got her home. The one, you know, she gave to him, and Shannon, basically, he stole from her from getting the mortgage and getting money on her home. It is so just appalling to me how movies like this and movies written by someone like Tyler Perry like perpetuate this notion of black women settling for less. And what pisses me off is, if this was a white character, there is no way that the script would have been written like that, because it is accepted, it is just understood that if a white woman is married to a man who owns a mortgage company and is living in this big beautiful house, that she's gonna get half and then some. And it's crazy, because the husband, Shannon, this younger guy, was able to do everything to her and destroy her financially and still her money, because he was her husband. And yet Grace was this man's wife for over 20 years, and she received no benefits of that marriage. Nothing. She didn't even get her own house. And it is so offensive to me that Tyler Perry would write a script and a character and depict a black woman as unworthy of what is reasonable and customary for any woman in her situation. If a white man had written and submitted this script to Netflix, they would have rejected it. They would have said, dude, this is racist, this is, you know, demeaning to black women, and just offensive to black women. But you know what? It's coming from Tyler Perry, and he is a black man, and his audience is primarily black women. So, you know, if Tyler says it's okay, it must be okay. Another issue I have with Tyler Perry and how this movie was written was, like, how the young black lawyer, the woman who defended Grace, how she was treated. the Tyler Perry DA character berated the attorney for trying to help her and thinking that, hey, this woman has been wronged in some way and she is deserving of a trial. This movie, which was written and directed by Tyler Perry, just reminds me of how many black men do not support black women, that, you know, how they don't paint us in a favorable and positive light. They don't support us. They don't see us as prizes. When I saw this movie and Grace and how she was depicted, I said, thank you, Jesus, for putting this hypergamy for women 40 and over on my mind and for starting this channel specifically for women like us. Because the development, encouragement, and empowerment of women our age is desperately needed, so we can avoid or at least be aware of and recognize predators. And on the flip side, be able to recognize and appreciate good men. A Fall from Grace is the perfect example of why women 40 and over must be hypergamous. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please comment below. I always look forward to reading your comments and getting your feedback. Once again, thank you so much for supporting this channel, this new channel. Spread the word, and I hope you will still continue to support Pretty in Things. I'm actually going to move my hypergamy videos from Pretty in Things to this channel as soon as I figure out how to do it. So until next time, you guys, mwah.